This is episode 3 from the Server Guy Server. I'm in the Nether, as you can see. Why did I come to Nether? Well, one, I wanted to see if I can get some gas tiers just while I was here. And I don't know where the fortress is, so we'll get to that some other time. So, is that it over there? No, I have no idea where it is. So, get blaze rods and all that good stuff some other time. But yeah, I wanted to come here and get some gas tiers and just see if I could cook up some food. I didn't have much coal, but on the way here I actually went down a cave and found lots of coal. But yeah, I'm going to just stay here and cook up some food, and if I happen upon some gas, then I'll get those. I already got one tier. And yeah, so I'll go here, stay for a bit, cook up some food, put all my uncooked food, hang around here and... No, I'm not going to get that. That looks like a recipe for disaster. So, that is worrying. Okay. I'm going to just go the other way. I guess something interesting is up here because his torches seem to be showing me the way, but I'm just going to go. Things are acting strange, so I'll just leave. I can hear a few ghasts floating around as well. I only got one tier. Just the one. So yeah, I'm going to come back and do fortress things some other time, I think. Well, I'm back, and it's been quite a long time, and lots of stuff has happened. Most of it not good. Let me fill you in. So, we lost the world. Sounds dramatic. We lost the world, and the game was reset. Well, our world was reset back a couple of days, I think. So most of the stuff that I had done after that point that I left off and said I was going to work on it, that was lost. So, and I did quite a lot. And yeah, so I had to kind of do it again. So this is where I am now. I finished this kind of transitional area here, and I thought it might be nice to make it go down on the left side and then up on the right. So let's go up first. So I've tried to hide most of the lighting. At least I've tried to hide most of the lighting in the places that I finished. Up here is not quite finished yet, and this is going to be the bedroom area. I'm not sure how much more I'm going to extend this part out. I don't want to take up too much room going this way. I did think about having an entrance here, so it'd be nice to have two entrances at least to my house. Doesn't quite work out because there's a lot of buildings in the way over there. Nobody's living around here, I don't think, so I don't think it'd be too much of a problem, but I don't really want to extend it too far out that way. I would like to have another entrance though. So I just fixed up this this farm area here. It was all trampled up, and there was water all over the place, so I fixed that up so it might be nice to look out of the window when I wake up in the morning. This way I'm gonna do something here. I'm not finished anyway. This part is not finished, but it's easier for me to run up here and go to sleep than it was to go up to the second floor main area and go to sleep. So I've kind of finished this. I like to keep the kind of messed up kind of feeling since we're in this messed up city. I don't want everything to be so perfect, so these stairs are kind of messed up here, and there's a few places where you can see rooms over on the other side, like this through here. There was actually another church next to this one, so I think I'm going to keep that as a theme throughout most of what I do in the city here, where you can see bits of other things, and there's like doors where there maybe oughtn't to be doors. Yeah, and then I've got some nether wart as I placed here before. I had to replace that. Yeah, most of that was lost, but no big deal. And this area here, I'm still not sure what I'm going to do here. One idea was to have it as a storage area with lots of chests, but I'm not sure I really need that because I have the chest here, and I have these here now, these little ones here. And as for cobblestone and the... Ah, server resets. Good old server resets. Cut me off in mid-flow. Yeah, so I don't really need that storage. The stuff that's that usually builds up, like cobblestone and gravel and dirt, I put it in the kind of community storage down the bottom of the hill there. So I'm not really going to keep a load of that stuff. If I want cobblestone or dirt or gravel, I'll just go down there and get it anyway. So I don't really think I need masses of storage just yet. So another idea was just to have this as a brewing room. Again, I'm not really sure I need that. I'm so close to the park and there is one there already. I'm just going to wait, I think, and see what we do with the park in terms of community stuff there. Another idea I had was because I want to open a shop that sells dyes and things like that, so I may have this as a dye room. So, you know, when you make the flowers like roses and the lilacs and the sunflowers, you bone meal them and you can get loads of those. So I might set that up here along with some other things and have this as a dye room. And then I started making that shop area around here. Okay, it's night time. Still a little bit dangerous here. I started making the shop area just to think about what I was going to do with it. So I kind of opened it up here a little bit and I've kind of thought about what I'm going to do. I think I'm going to do that. If I do that, that means I'm going to have to gather quite a lot of resources. So I'd like to have all of them, and I think there are 16 different colours that you can have. That's including the bone meal and the ink sacks. So that is going to be kind of a long process because there isn't really a good place to make an ink farm right now. I mean, I could do it, but it won't be like a mega, super awesome productive one. But I think I can do it, and we have a couple of skeleton spawners. They haven't been kind of developed yet, but they have been found. Cecile found, I think she found 4 spawners, skeletons and spider spawners, I think they were. So I think that's what I will do. Roses and lilacs are quite plentiful around this area. The thing I don't have is sunflowers. So I am going to try and find some sunflowers. And if you remember, in this world, we have a world border set up. And apparently it's centered around the park over there, and it goes out from 1,000 blocks in each direction. So there's no risk of me accidentally exploring too much terrain, that kind of thing. So I think that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to pack up my things and get myself ready, and I'm going to go on a bit of a sunflower adventure. So catch up with you when I'm out in the wilds. I've just gone past the nether portal, which is back over there, heading this direction, going towards going heading north, right? And yeah, I've just come across this other kind of fairly large village, generated in much the same way ours was, but this is much, much smaller. And there's still some villagers here. I'm so surprised that they're actually still alive. And we did kill them. I guess we killed him with a command, and perhaps the command was only in a radius, but yeah, this guy's still alive, and he's outside. How is he still alive? Anyway, well, good luck to you, sir. Good luck to you. I guess you won't be around when I come back. Let's keep moving here. I would say, judging by the people that are on this server, this place has probably been picked through the blacksmiths and any goodies they might have had in the past. So I'm not going to bother checking around too much here. There are some more villagers there too. I'm so surprised that they're still alive. Well, there's quite a lot of them. Librarians. I might have to check those, because if they have good books... Oh, I can't resist. I cannot resist. Just checking what he's got. Bane of Arthropods. Nope. Sharpness 5 for 48 emeralds. What a bargain. What a bargain. Power 3 for 17. That's not bad. That's not bad at all. Right. Well, I'm not really going to check any of these guys. The librarians are the only ones that really interest me. And even these ones aren't too interesting. Excuse me, sir. I'm just going to get past here. Else interesting? Let's go up high and see what we can see. I did see another librarian. That's one over there, isn't there? Isn't it? I don't have loads of emeralds at the moment, but oh, that's rubbish. But if the right villager were to come along, he might be worth saving. Especially seeing as though there aren't any in our village. Punch one. Well, these are all pretty mediocre guys, aren't they? You're in danger. I wouldn't really be staying here if I were you. Anyway, I'm going to leave these guys to fend for themselves, and I'm just going to carry on in an aimless direction, seeing if I can find the elusive sunflowers. No, that would be wrong. I don't need the iron. I've got loads of iron. Let's keep them protected at least. Oh, there's another one. Well, this village isn't doing too bad, is it? This village isn't doing too bad at all. I don't know if we want these villagers to hang around though. This might not be what we really want. Yeah, I'm not sure if we want these villagers hanging around. They were the cause of the lag. That's why we got rid of the other ones. Lure 3. You like fishing, and I do like fishing. So don't know what the guys want to do about that. Leave them be. As far as I'm concerned, the lag and stuff is much, much better than it was before, so I don't know if we want to do anything with those or leave them. I'd like to have some villagers, at least good ones. I mean, we don't need a thriving metropolis of villagers, but it's nice to have them for the trading, because those infinity books don't just come up every day. Oh, okay. I think Tulkas said he found... this must be the forest that Tulkas found, because he was on a quest for Dark Oak. A successful quest, I think. This must be... Silk Touch pick. Yeah, I do, so... Silk Touch still works on mushrooms, doesn't it? Not in the way it used to. But it does still work. Block's a block. A rare block is a rare block, and I don't think many people have Silk Touch yet. Let's test it out. I can't remember what you get from it. I think you just get the brown. You get these from it. Potato. The fool. Okay, you get those garish red guys. I mean, they'll be useful for something. Surely must be useful for something. I'm not quite sure what though. I haven't really ever seen a build that has used these bright red polka dot spotted things in a tasteful way. We'll see. It's a challenge. It's another challenge, and this map is all about the challenge. Sure, I'm worthy of such a challenge, but we'll see. Anyway, I'm getting sidetracked, so I'll tootle around here for a bit, and then when this rain has stopped, we'll see where we've got to. Right, so here we are again in the cold light of day, and we've hit the border. So doesn't look like we've been lucky on this side of the map as it stands now. Bam. So maybe we'll just skirt around the edges. I haven't really done any exploring, so it's quite interesting to see what direction we might want to spread out in when 1.9 finally drops. So I'm going to skirt around and see what we can find. I do need squid as well. So grab these guys too. Yeah, it's going to be hard to run this shop, and I'm not sure how successful it's going to be. But I think it's going to be a fun little thing to try and do. Yeah. I collected a load of clay earlier today as well. I had a bit of a grindy day today. Since there was a fair amount of stuff that I had to get back after the reset. There were some diamonds that I'd found just before I logged off, the night that we lost the world, and And I went back to the place, and I think I managed to get maybe not the exact same diamonds, but I think I got a similar amount from the same area, so I'm happy with that. And I went caving today, and I got another load of diamonds, so yeah, I have to show those when we get back home. What a beautiful sight. This is good. It's not what I was looking for, but this will do nicely. Found a desert. I don't think anyone's found cactus or anything like that yet, so this is a nice find. And it does mean that now I have green dye available to me, which unlocks a few more colours, which is going to be good if I want my shop to be fully stocked. I haven't seen any acacia trees, obviously, either in anyone's build, since we haven't found those biomes yet. As far as I know, anyway, somebody might be hoarding their acacia somewhere, but I haven't seen anybody using it anywhere. So I'm going to just collect a few of these. Of course, we can set up somewhere to grow them in the city when we get back there, assuming we get back safe and sound. But this is not what I was looking for. It's good, but it's not exactly what I was looking for. I'm going to keep going in a direction and see what else we find. Well, I have hidden for the night and reached the other side of the world border and level 30. That's it for the good news. So we're going to change direction again. Still nothing on the other side of the world border that's going to tease me. These pigs want to get over there too. Yeah, nothing of any note over that side. Not really sure where we are in relation to the village. It doesn't, well, the city. It doesn't really matter anyway. I'm not ready to go yet. I'm not ready to go. I'm not ready to give up just yet. I'm going to head in a bit. In and up a little bit, see what I can see from the top of this area here. Oh, slick. At all. Huh, brown sheep. I don't think so. So the brown sheep is a rare beast. The brown wool. I don't have any sheep. I don't really. I'm not that bothered about brown wool. But if anybody is, come over here and pick yourself up some brown wool. I'm going to keep going along here. Left and the right. Up to the world border. Border's on my left. And there doesn't seem to be anything of any description. I'm going to keep going, and I think this is going to end soon. I have to believe that it's going to end soon. It's going to end in a ravine. So I'm going to skirt around. I haven't seen any dogs or anything hanging around here either. That would be nice. I don't think anyone's got dogs yet either. Clearly somebody has been exploring. Oh! Speaking of which, doggies. Should we try and snag a few doggies? Hello? Oh. Hello? Oh. Great. Let's go, guys. You can be my lucky mascots, as long as you don't get yourselves killed along the way. Right, I'm probably going to have to stop recording soon, because my family will be returning home. So this may be cut short. We may have disappointment to end it. video of me finding sunflowers once I stop being able to record. Still going to keep heading in this direction. Something for donkey lovers. So we've reached some kind of plains area. It is plains. Oh, yes. I didn't even notice those. I bet you noticed them before I did. Excellent. Excellent. Mission accomplished. Ah, that is good. That is a good way to finish, I think. It's a good way to finish. Dump that. So, what do we get? Let's recap. We found cactus. We found doggies. And we found sunflowers. So we found what we wanted to, and more. That's a bonus. So that's it's a good bonus for everybody to have. Dogs who want dogs, and cactus who want cactus for whatever reason. And it's great for me too. I don't really need this many, but you know, they're here. Should we leave some? No, there's some over there. It's fine. It's fine. That's great. All right. Well. Okay, guys. Let's say goodbye here, and we'll be back next time. And we'll start our dying empire. All right, take it easy. Bye-bye.